Hello, everybody. Welcome to the 9th Mika Fan Club Instagram Live. Can't believe we're already at 9 weeks into this. It's so good to see people starting to fill up the room. Every week, I wonder if it's just going to be me talking to myself. So I'm glad to see some people here. I can say ciao, tutti, salut, hola, guten Abend. I tried to expand my repertoire, and I know I'm not going to say this right, but guten avond, is that Dutch for good evening? I think I had a request from a Dutch fan, since there are quite a few Dutch people watching. Anyway, welcome to everybody, no matter where you are in the world. It's good to see you here. For those of you who don't know me, although I think I recognize most of the names that are popping up on the screen here already, but I'm Deb from Mika Fan Club. I'm the administrator of MikaFanClub.com, and I'm very happy to see so many people here popping in. I have a little bit of an agenda this week, but we're still going to be doing basically what we did last week, trying to bring in as many fans as we can to talk about all different kinds of things. But, you know, Mika is what has brought us together, so that will be the starting point of all of our conversations. People are asking, how am I doing? That's very kind of you. I'm doing okay, but I have to say, I'm getting a little tired of the lockdown, and I think maybe that's because I'm starting to see some places open up and restrictions are starting to relax. How are you all doing? What's going on where you are? When I talk to you guys today, I'd like to find out what the rest of the world is doing. I think that people are starting to get a little restless, and I hope that we're not going to do too much too soon, and that we're not going to forget why we did the lockdown for the last couple of months. I'd like to say happy birthday to anybody who has had a birthday in the last week or so. I can imagine it's been weird to not be able to celebrate with your family and friends the way you would normally do. So I hope that you were able to have a good time and or maybe postpone your celebrations for a little bit later in the year. Let's see, I'm seeing people say France is coming out of confinement. I know, that's great. And I hope that you all are still going to stay safe. I'm in the state of Virginia here in the United States, and most of my state is going to open up or has been opening up gradually, but I'm in the northern part of Virginia, which is near Washington, D.C., and a pretty dense population, and so our area is still not opening. We have a lot of restrictions still. Yeah, I'm seeing, let's see, people have, beaches are allowed, no cinemas in France, no cafes. Yeah, in this Northern Virginia area, we don't have anything really open yet. I was able to go to a nursery to buy some plants, some flowers and things for my garden and my back deck to decorate. And that was kind of weird because a lot of people weren't wearing face masks. And there were just so many people. They were all real close together. I was a little uncomfortable with that. So I don't know. I'm still not quite ready to have things go 100% back to normal the way they used to be. Let's see. Germany is loosening restrictions pretty fast. Yeah. I think that I worry that some of the world is going too fast too soon, but I'm a pretty cautious person, I guess. So we'll see. Austria is out of lockdown. Life is getting a bit more normal. Well, that's good to hear. Somebody can go to the hairdressers again in the Netherlands. That's fantastic because I really need a haircut, as I know a lot of people are saying. Daisy says she lives in a seaside town but can't visit the beach because there's so many tourists. Yeah, we're going to go to the beach in New Jersey this weekend. It's a holiday weekend. Memorial Day here in the States is Monday, and so the weekend is traditionally the kickoff of the summer season, and we usually go to the beach. My husband's family has a house there, and we're going to go and see what that's like. I wonder if how many people are going to be there. Italy is trying to open up. Yeah, I can imagine. Let's see, somebody did go to the hairdresser today. Well, that's good. I wish I could. Anyhow, let's see. So, as I said, I'd like to bring a lot of you in, but before I do, I just wanted to very quickly say kind of an update on what's happening with the Mika Fan Club yearbook. That is in the proofreading stage right now, and I am starting to work on laying out some pages. So that's kind of rolling along. And the birthday present is also rolling along, and I am not sure if people can still join that project. You would need to contact Anne on the forum on MikaFanClub.com, and she would be able to help. She is crazy about Mika, and she'd be able to give you an idea of what's going on with that. The comments have stopped scrolling on my screen. Oh, there we go. And so I couldn't see what people were saying. Let's see. So that's, you know, not much of an update, just that the projects are rolling along, and hopefully the yearbook will stay on schedule. A lot of that is on me, I guess, as far as getting the layout done. And I have a lot of time right now, so I should be able to get it done on schedule. And I just don't know when, once we finish it, when we will get it to Mika. We probably won't get it to him in person this year, unless we wait until, you know, towards the end of the year. We might have to settle for just mailing it off to him this year. I also thought I would update you on Mika news. Unfortunately, there isn't any. We don't even have any vacuum cleaner news this week. Well, that's not entirely true. I guess Mika did do an interview with a Montreal radio station over the weekend, because, or a French-Canadian, I'm not sure if it was Montreal, but because he was supposed to perform there this past weekend. And that interview has been translated by the Mika Fan Club subtitling team from French into Italian and into English. So if you're interested in seeing that, they have, it's an audio only, but they have it on YouTube with subtitles. And you can get the links for that on MikaFanClub.com. Yeah, Wesley, Mika news is there's no news. I did also want to address, though, sort of in the world of Mika news, there's a lot of rumors floating around. There's a rumor that he's going to rejoin X Factor in Italy again, that he's going to be doing a live stream for people, that he's going to be doing festivals in the fall. And all I have to say is those are just rumors. We don't know for sure anything yet. And we can't really consider anything official until Mika's team tells us. And once they tell me that, yes, it's happening, then, of course, we'll announce it. They'll announce it. Mika will probably announce it on his social media as well. But yeah, just hang tight. There's been nothing definite announced. And so all of those things that you might see on Twitter or, you know, on random blogs, those are all just rumors. We don't have any confirmation on any of that. So that's about the extent of the Mika news that we have. Let's see. I think that's pretty much all that I wanted to talk to you about. I did have one other thing. Somebody sent me a photo today and I was going to share it with you. Let's see if I can. Let's see. There, can you see this photo? Somebody sent it to me. This is me talking to Mika 5 years ago. It was May of 2015 after a show in New York City. And it just came to me out of the blue, and I really do appreciate Stefania is the fan who sent this to me. And you sometimes get to meet Mika, but you don't normally get a photo commemorating the experience. So this was kind of fun. And well, I'm tiny height-wise compared to Mika. Yeah, I'm only 5'1" and he's 6'3" or 6'4", whatever. So yeah, he's got a good foot plus on me. 2015 was 5 years ago, and in some ways, it doesn't seem like 5 years, but in other ways, it seems like it was a lifetime ago. Indy says she remembers walking after that. Yeah, you're there, and your sister is right behind me in that photo, Indy, if you can see. And I don't know if anybody else who's here in this chat right now. I see Dee is there, Creature. She's there in this picture. And Nina, I think maybe that's Nina. Kind of standing right in front of Mika. But anyway, it was an unexpected treat to get this photo today, so I thought I would share it. It was in New York City, after a show he had done at, I think it was Webster Hall. And, May 15th or 16th, something like that, the middle of May, in 2015. So it was almost exactly 5 years. So that was kind of cool. Yeah. Anyway, it was kind of fun. How do I get rid of this now? Okay. There. So that's really all I have. I'm going to try now to bring some of you in to talk to us. Like I said, the subject today is kind of Mika art, or art as it relates to Mika, and I am going to bring a few people in if I can. Let's see who's here. Wesley had said that he would talk with us a little bit about the album cover art. Wesley, you did not request to be in here, but I'm going to see if I can bring you in anyway. Are you ready? Tell me you're ready. He's not ready. He's not ready. Okay, well, let's see who else is here. Oh, let me see. Sorry, here, technical difficulties. Okay, well, Florine and Laurie from Mika Art Vibes are going to be launching an Instagram Live tomorrow, I think, talking about their art. And Florine had said she would come and talk to us a little bit about the artwork that she's been doing and what she has planned for her Instagram Live. And we're connecting. Hi. And she's there. Yeah. Hi. Hi, Florine.
Can you hear me?
How are you?
I'm fine, thanks. What about you?
Oh, I can't hear you now.
You can't hear me?
Now I can.
Okay. How are you?
I'm well. How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you. I'm here with my friend Lori because we have this account in common. So okay. She's here. Hi.
Okay. Hello.
Yeah. She's my first fan, so I have to bring her with me.
No, that's great. That's great. So
yeah, so I'm so glad to be here because you called me twice before and I was like, okay, but what can I say? Because I can dance, I can sing, I can play any music. So right. Now it's nice because as you see, Lori and I have a little project in common because we made this account, Mikart Vibes. Mm-hmm. And we want to bring some people with us. Because we're doing a live tomorrow, and there's a lot of people who have talent. They dance, they sing, but there's a lot of people who doesn't have many talents. And I think, personally, that we all have a talent by being who we are.
Yes,
so,
I would agree.
Yeah, that's something really special for the two of us, because we want to bring people. And if anyone can... I don't know, draw, writing, they can send us a message and we're here to talk to them. And it's always hard to be a fan of Mika at the beginning because we don't know how it is, what to do. And Lori and I are here to talk with people, and there's always an answer for you if you need.
Oh, very nice. Very nice. Yeah. So. Are you going to show some of your art during the live? And
yeah, personally, I can't draw anything. But Lori is an artist. She's an artist. She's really great. And she's saying no. But yeah, you are. And I write. I love to write. I really love to play with words. And so Lori's gonna show some draws she made. So,
okay.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, so, yeah, it's gonna be fun. We don't pretend to be professional. We don't have anything to say, but it's gonna be fun because we're just us. So,
okay. So, you said you have this project. Have you started writing and working on this already? Is there anything
can you give us a little preview? Yeah, we have a little project because Lori was thinking about the Lebanon, something really important to Mika, and we really want to do something.
Okay.
So she's gonna... Yeah, she's a little shy, but she's going to show her work, and I'm going to write.
Okay, good. That's
yeah,
great.
Yeah, and it's tomorrow, 4:30, and everybody can come say hi, and you don't have to be talented to come because it's all good. We're all the same, and it's just a place for us to be together.
Right. Right.
So Lori she would just want to say something in French.
Okay, good.
Oui, donc pour les fans français, je vais traduire ce qu'a dit Florine. Donc en gros, on va faire un live sur notre compte Mikart Vibe. Et on va montrer des dessins, on va lire des textes et tout. Et donc ceux qui veulent passer, montrer des dessins ou quelque chose, ils peuvent. Et même si vous n'avez pas de talent particulier, mais si vous voulez juste partager un moment avec nous, vous êtes les bienvenus. Voilà, on accueille tout le monde ici.
Okay. Yeah, she's great, right?
Yes. So I think she showed some of her art couple weeks ago.
Yeah, you called her, I think it was 2 weeks ago, maybe.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. She's
Well,
so
very.
I'm very happy.
Very talented, and I will be very anxious to see what you come up with.
Yeah, but so I really want to thank you. Because it's amazing to be able to talk about everything. So thank you for
calling
me.
Well, yeah. Are you going to put it into a book when it's done? Or
actually, Lori did an amazing art book she gave to Mika after the gig in Strasbourg, and he was like, "Okay, it's amazing." So maybe she's gonna put everything she does into a new book. Maybe
okay.
We don't know. That's okay. A surprise. No, I'm kidding.
Well, good. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for sharing. And
thank
so,
you.
And what time? It's tomorrow at?
Tomorrow, 4:30.
Okay. And somebody was asking, the account is Mika?
Mikart_vibes.
Okay. MIKART.
Underscore
vibes. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, great. Well, thank you so much for talking with us about it. And I'll try to pop in tomorrow if I remember, if I can.
Okay. It's my pleasure. Right. Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye. Okay. Okay. Wesley, I see you're there. Are you ready to talk to us or not? Wesley, answer me. Are you ready to talk if I call you in? Let's see. Here you are. I'm trying again, Wesley. It says waiting. It says connecting.
Hi.
Ah,
there. Hey, hi, Deb.
Okay, how are you?
How are you? I'm fine. Well. Fine, thank you.
It's lovely to see your face.
Yeah. Say the same after this. Oh my God, this time it's good to see you.
Yes, it's been a while.
Yeah.
So for people who don't know who you are, maybe you could introduce yourself a little bit.
Whoa. Okay.
And then tell us, you know, what we were talking about yesterday. The art, the album art, right?
Okay. Well, hi, I'm Wesley. I'm Brazilian in origin, but I'm living in France now. I came here to do my master's. And, I'm like a fan from like 2008, 2009, something like that. Long, long time ago. And my first gig was this February in Strasbourg. It was.
I can't believe that.
Yeah, me neither. I still can't believe it that happened. And it's amazing. It's something that I still cannot talk about it because I still don't understand how that happened. It's like something magical. And do you want to talk in French too? I don't know.
Yes. Yeah. If you can just say a few words in French, that I'm sure people would appreciate.
Okay. J'étais en train de m'introduire. Je m'appelle Wesley. Je suis brésilien, mais j'habite en France depuis 8 mois. Une chose comme ça. Je suis venu pour faire mon master. Et j'ai dit que j'ai de Mika depuis 2008-2009. Et mon premier concert, c'était à Strasbourg en février. C'était incroyable. Je n'ai pas encore des mots pour traduire tout ça, et voilà. Et c'est une chose incroyable de dire la magie que Mika peut donner aux gens, et voilà, c'est bien ça. Voilà. I think I said.
I've never heard you speak French before, that's funny. So we're trying to talk about different art projects and art as it relates to Mika. And so you're doing your master's on the album art?
No, I'm doing my master's in culture and contemporary creation and cultural industries, like a culture in a general way. And I'm doing my dissertation about art, about music art. And the design of the cover art, and I'm using Björk as base, as my line. And of course, I will talk about Mika because it's impossible.
Right.
I did a part when I use an author, Doelker. He wrote something about the divisions of art, like in 4 ways, and I found 2. Of this description that I've put both some Mika's covers. And for example, I took the first 3 parts of the albums, like the imagined, like he said, imagine in a subjunctive, like in a once upon a time thing, like a creation of a fictionary word that starts and somehow it goes away. Like the concept of Parc des Princes. And the three first albums, like Life in Cartoon Motion, The Boy Who Knew Too Much, and Songs for Sorrow, had this aura, had this thing that is something that it created to exist for a time, and after it's go away, it never happened. And like a fairy tale, like something for kids that's just happened for a time and after it's done. And like Mika said once, when he continued to work on his albums, the first album was a teenager, and then like growing up, and the last one, My Name is Michael Holbrook, like more adult thing. It's like a form of ideality. I like this author said, and others too. Like a being ideal word, like a creator, like a creation of ideal word, like in any other word, something like that. And points of hyper-realism, like he said, when he was in this cover, like the last cover, when he used his face and other images, like a collage from the 80s, Andy Warhol, those influences that have come from this form of reality. So we can also see the lyrics, the same thing from, example, I don't know, any other word, it's like a creation of a special place, like the cover, mm-hmm. and ice cream, I don't know, for my name is Mike Holbrook, is like an idealization of a moment that is possible, but idealization. It's like a nothing really.
Right.
So we can see this evolution thing in Mika's cover that as Mika's lyrics. So something that I'm talking about too.
Well, that'll be really interesting. I saw someone was talking on Twitter, I happened to see, and they were talking about Mika's album covers.
Mm-hmm.
And they said how on all of the album covers, he's in black and white, where everything mm-hmm. else is in color.
Yeah.
And I thought that was pretty interesting, because I had to go back and look to see.
Mm-hmm.
But
he's
in black and white.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And
but if he's in the cover, he's in black and white.
Yeah.
To give this distinction from the art, to make a distance between him and the art.
Yeah. I thought that was really, I mean, there's not a lot of color on this,
mm-hmm.
obviously,
yeah.
but he's still black even and white. I actually even wondered about this cover when I saw it. You know, why mm-hmm. why did they choose to do black and white? So it's interesting.
Yeah.
Like you said, it's creating an image that's not real. It's something that's not real.
Yeah.
So yeah. Well, that's very cool. So I didn't know that's what you were studying, or what you were, you know, why you were in France. I didn't realize. So that's kind of cool.
Yeah. It's good.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you.
I have you here, how are you doing? How has the whole experience been for you? You know, you come to France and
mm-hmm.
suddenly you're restricted.
Yeah.
You can't go anywhere.
Yeah. Sometimes it's tough. Sometimes it's really tough. But thanks, as I said to you other times, I'm really glad about Mika, because he gave me so great friends, like family, and in France, in Germany, all over around, in Brazil. And I'm blocked in Limoges, in the middle of nothing in France.
Right.
And I can't go to see the other people, but I still feel like that I'm close to friends, I'm close to people that I can talk, and you're living the same thing that I'm living.
Yeah.
So that's a good thing.
Okay.
It's not that hard.
Well, good. And I think you make friends pretty easy. You have, I see all the people on the screen here. Everybody knows who you are. So I think that's great. I'm glad that I got to see you. I'm glad I got to see you in person.
Yeah,
but
me
I'm
too.
glad that he's here now. So, yeah. Well, thank you very much. And I'll say goodbye for now, but I'll see you again soon, I hope.
Yeah, and, me too. Thank you. Bye. Stay safe.
You too.
Que bye-bye. Says. Beijos. Bye.
Okay. Yeah, I met Wesley in Brazil. I went to Brazil a few years ago with my family, and it was not Mika related at all, but we got to spend a day with him, and it was wonderful. And I think it's one of the cool things about following Mika is that I have been able to meet people even not related to going to concerts, and get to know a few people that I've really become very good friends with, that's been a great experience, great part of this whole Mika thing. As I was looking at the comments, somebody asked me if I liked potatoes, and I'm not sure why. Why did you ask me that? I do like potatoes, but surely you must have had a reason for asking me. And I can't remember who it was that asked. Was it Daniela? Yeah, I like potatoes. Fine. But I don't know why. Anyway, I'm going to try to bring in somebody else. I see Vicky Suarez, maybe. Vicky, have you requested to join the live? Am I going to put you onto the spot? Oh, no, you're there. I'm going to see if I can bring you in. And maybe we can talk a little bit about some of the stuff that you have done.
Hi.
Hi. How are you?
Sorry. Oh, here.
Oh, good.
Hi.
How are you? I'm well. Thanks.
Oh, I'm well too. I'm actually, as you posted today, thank you so much. It really means a lot to me. You posted this one that I have over here, this painting.
Yes.
I did a while ago.
You did that great video.
Hi, thank
how you.
You
made it, and it was fantastic. And unfortunately, I couldn't post the music with it because Instagram keeps blocking my videos when I post. They did it again just the other day when I posted a song.
Yeah.
But it was great to see how you made that.
Oh,
and I
thank
just thought
you.
That was such a great. So, tell me a little bit about yourself. Where are you at? I don't know where you're located.
Oh, I'm in my room. I'm from Argentina, South America.
Argentina.
We're in quarantine. Yes, quarantine. We're in quarantine right now. I'm like this. but yes, I'm going through virtual classes, and I have some time to paint and all that stuff. So I wanted to show you some of my stuff over here.
I would love to see it. And let me just ask you this. Mika hasn't been to Argentina for a long time. Did you get to see him when he was here?
No, I did not.
Yeah.
He was going to come to Lollapalooza in March. I wasn't going to see him, but they were going to stream the festival on TV, so I was going to see him. But
right.
I couldn't. I very new at the fandom. It just surprises me how long have some of guys over here been.
Yeah. Old timers.
Yes.
Well, please let's see some of the work that you have done. Yeah.
It's very simple compared to what I've done. The hand of say hi, but I did this
a photo frame.
Yes, of life in cartoon motion.
Yes.
Also, I only have two more. I haven't had that much time yet, but I'm looking forward to do more. This one, it's very simple, but it's from Platform Ballerinas, one of my favorite songs.
Yes.
That.
Yeah.
And this one also from Stardust. I don't know if you can see it because it's the other way. But that's it. I wanted to ask you if you could tell me some ideas.
Oh, for you to make some art?
Yes. Oh, I ran out of them.
Well, you know, if I had been going to suggest something, I would have probably said something like Stardust, because I think it's such a beautiful song, and it evokes such strong feelings, you know, such strong emotions. Maybe from the new album, maybe something from like Paloma.
Oh, that's very beautiful, yes.
Yeah, with the dove. And yeah, I think that could be something really pretty.
Okay.
Do you like to just like paint? Is it oil paint that you were doing?
Acrylic over this kind of cloth over here.
Yeah.
By now it's that. For now it's that. I'm looking forward to keep trying new like techniques, but I'm not a professional.
No, well, I the only thing I use a pencil for is to write. I can't draw anything, so I'm always impressed when I see somebody who has a talent for it like that. So I think that's great, and I really appreciate talking with you and that you came on.
Thank you.
I just really loved the video that you did, and I know I posted it at the time, but then I saved the very end, the last shot, because I thought that was such a cool picture. So somebody is suggesting late Mika's song Lady Jane to you, I think. Yeah.
Lady Jane. Okay.
Yeah, Lady Jane was on the Songs for Sorrow EP. Yeah, that could be interesting too.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. Well, thank you very much.
Oh, thank you. I've seen a lot of people saying that. I feel so loved. Like, complimenting my work. Thank you so much. Like, that's all I have to say. I may not be able to dance or sing, but I can paint, at least.
Well, we'll look forward to seeing what you come up with in the future. You know, be sure to tag Mika Fan Club if you post it on Instagram, and I'll try to share it with everybody.
Of course. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you. Take care. We'll talk again soon. Bye.
Bye.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know if you guys remembered the video, but she did a whole video where she showed how she made that painting, with the stay high and the hand, and it was so cool. And like, not being an artist, it was really impressive to me. So let's see here. Do we have anybody else who would like to share some artwork with us? Or let's see. I have Upside Terry. Let's see, Terry. We are trying to connect. Oh, no, she declined. All right. Karen, you can't see anything. You can just hear. Every week it's a different challenge, isn't it? It's more different technical problems. Let's see here. We'll try Fanny. Fanny, would you like to join us? Let's see. Someone from Israel. Hi, Fanny. Oh, you're in the car.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you, Deb?
In the car. I am good. How are you?
Yes, you I'm fine. And you?
I'm very well, thank you. Are you able to talk now? I can see you. I can hear you.
Okay, good. Sorry, I've not art, or I can't sing anything.
That's okay. That's okay. We can still talk. So,
hello. So, I would like to know, what is your favorite album?
My favorite album. It's so hard. I really love this. My name is Michael Holbrook.
Oh.
I think
the new,
Yeah. It might be my favorite, except that sometimes I think I really, really loved Origin of Love. And I love most of the songs there. So it's really hard to choose. Really hard to choose.
Yes, it's very hard to choose.
Yeah.
It's the same thing for the song. It's hard to choose the song you sorry for my English.
No, it's great.
I'm in France.
Ah.
But I know you don't speak very well French.
No, I can say je ne parle pas français. Is that
you must learn French.
I study.
You must.
I should.
Perhaps you can come in France, in Paris, if Mika do a live a concert. It will be good for you.
I would love it. I haven't been to France for many years. It's been more than 10 years. So I am due to go. But yeah. Go ahead.
Sorry? Excuse me.
I was going to ask, what's your favorite album?
Me, it's the first. The first.
The first.
Life in Motion Cartoon is my favorite album. Really?
Uh-huh.
Et during the en français confinement during the I heard this.
Uh-oh, she's frozen.
Because Relax is my favorite song too.
Ah, okay. Good. I think that's a lot of people's favorite songs. A lot of people love Relax.
And the show to the Parc des Princes is beautiful and wonderful, but I can't see this show only in video. Unfortunately.
Yeah. Oh, well. I didn't get to see it either. I wasn't there. Yes.
Perhaps another day. Perhaps.
Yes.
You come. You come. Yeah. It will be good if you come in Paris. Good.
I would like to. I have never seen Mika in a really huge arena or stadium show. I have only, the biggest show I think I ever saw him in was in New York. I think it was 5,000 people.
Oh yeah. New York. Yeah.
So I've never seen
a big concert. Yes. I understand.
Like Bercy or any of the Italian arenas.
No. Oh, this
one day.
One day, yes, of course. In December, I've seen Mika in Paris to the Accor Hotel Arena.
Uh-huh.
It was wonderful. It was big. It was with il chante avec un chœur avec des chanteur gospel.
Oh yes,
it was very nice.
Voices of Gospel, yeah.
Voilà. Sorry, in English.
Yeah, no, that's no.
But
I figured
you understand. You understand. I'm sorry.
No, no, voilà. You're great. No, and everybody.
I'm very happy to see you again. I'm very happy to see you.
Yes. Yes, well, thank you so much for speaking with us. It was great.
Thanks. You to you for all you do with the Mika Fan Club and for us. It's very, very nice.
Well, that's nice. It's wonderful. It's my pleasure.
It's very wonderful. See you.
Well, thank you.
Later.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye. Okay. Let's see here. So Terry says she doesn't know how to speak in English, so that's why she couldn't talk to us. Let's see who else we have. We have Daisy. Oops. What is this? It's not responding here. Let's see. I'm going to try Manuela. Let's see here. And then I will see. It says waiting, connecting.
Hello?
Ciao,
Manuela. Hello. Oh my God, what a surprise. Sorry, but it's a surprise for me, okay? My God. Well, okay.
It's
so relaxed.
Hello. So hello. Where are you?
So my name is Manuela.
Yes.
So hello, everybody. I'm Italian.
Ciao.
I'm living in northern Italy, near Switzerland.
Okay.
And so I'm 43 years old. So
and a Mika fan for how long?
For 4 years, so not so much as you and the other girls here who are watching.
Yeah.
But I started to follow Mika when he started his show on TV, Casa Mika. So in previous year, yes, I've always listened to his most famous songs on the radio, like, for example, Can't Be Scary, Relax, Rain, and so on. But I didn't have so much time to to know him because I got married, I had children, so
my life was
yes very very busy, and so I didn't have much time to spend in listening to him and getting more information. But then things went better, and then I was a little bit quiet and started to watch this show on TV, and really I fall in love with him. This is weird because I found that Casa Mika was really a wonderful show, an amazing show, romantic, very interesting, funny. So it was a mixture of many things, and it was something that missed in Italy. It was it brought me to another world, and it was really really nice to see. And so I started to search in YouTube, in Google information. I read interviews, and so I watched at his concerts, and so I told to myself, okay, next tour I will be there. So when he announced that the Revolution Tour would have some dates in Italy, mm-hmm. so I searched, and I bought the ticket for Milano, the Forum. It was a very big arena.
Right.
And I went with my husband, so but I was in the steps, so I was not near the stage, so it was really an amazing experience. But then I wanted to see the show near the stage,
right.
And so I bought another ticket for another concert. And so I went to Padova with my sister-in-law on February, on the 2nd of February. And I was really under the stage, and I was in second row. And it was really another thing.
It's
really, it was completely different. Because he was really, really near me. And then when he went down while he was singing Platform Ballerina, It was he really walked near across me and really near me, and really I thought that I would faint because it was really I don't know how to express. I was feeling at that time. What it was really great. Yes. And then he has this talent to involve people, to be so fun, to tell stories about how he was inspired when he wrote some songs, and I think that it's really great, and so I bought another ticket for another concert.
Yes, I totally understand that.
Yes, I was supposed to go to Locarno on the 21st of June, but it was cancelled, so okay. That's a pity. But I think that Mika has the talent to write song which are able to talk to different people. In fact, we are fans of different ages, so there are young people and there are grown-up people, but anyone finds something in his music which make feel something beautiful, so I don't know, emotion, feelings, and I think that it's a great talent. Compared with maybe other artists which have maybe fans which are linking to are not all only young people or
right.
related to okay.
Yeah, I know what and you mean. Yeah, no, that Mika's fans are, you know, from little kids to grandmothers.
Yes.
And older, and yeah. So yes. And as you say, you buy one ticket to one show, and then you buy another,
yes.
And you buy another.
Yes, you can get enough.
Yes, it's
and so yes, it was so upset that due to coronavirus, I had to stop this
yes.
cycle because I really love it, but okay, safety. First, and so we have to postpone.
Absolutely, and yeah, we'll get
but
better.
I have to do it. Okay, we trying to jump. Behind me, sorry.
But things will get better, and we will, yeah. we'll carry on. So
Well,
thank you so much for talking with us. That's I'm delighted to have connected with you. And
thank you.
And I'm going to say ciao for now.
Ciao.
And
ciao.
I'm going to try to bring one more person in before we have to end today. So
yes.
Thank you. Grazie.
Bye, Dan.
Bye.
Have a nice day. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Okay. I am going to bring in one more person. I'm going to bring in Daisy. Oh, she's gone. I was going to bring in Daisy. Because I feel like maybe she had something she wanted to talk about. But she seems to have vanished. So I think we've only got about 5 minutes left. So Anna has had trouble connecting the last couple of weeks, and is 5 minutes going to be enough, Anna, if I bring you in? She says she thinks she will be able to connect this week and be able to sing a little bit for us. So she can maybe sing us out if that's going to be enough time.
Hello.
Ah, there she is.
Can
wow,
you
see? It worked.
Yes, today it worked. I think today, no technical problems for everybody. So
just very minor, yeah.
So we are lucky today.
yes. So we've got 4 minutes. Is that enough time for you to
okay? So we because the song has 3 minutes, I think.
Okay. All right.
Okay. Anna? So at last I will sing Blue for everybody and for you, Deb.
Okay, lovely, lovely. Anna from Poland.
For my stuff.
Oh, with a microphone, okay.
Blue is a feminine color. Blue is deep and blue. Blue is like no other. As sacred as its soul. Blue like the ocean's water. Watch it blue when it falls this way. Blue for your sons, not your daughters. Blue not for pleasure, but pain. All is to say that it's okay. No matter what life throws at you, I will always love the blue in you. I don't trust rainbows made by the sun. For a friend of many is a friend of none. Coming out of nowhere, but quick to wear. Like many others, and without friends, all is to say that it's okay. No matter what life throws at you, I will always love the blue. Green is pretty useful too, but now the deep and dark is blue. Red like the flame that burns in you, on the harvest color it is blue. Yellow beams is joyful power, but finally it takes out. While humans prove to you, your faithful friend, your truthful blue. All is to say that it's okay, no matter what life throws at you, I will always love the blue.
Ah. Well, third time was the charm, and it was worth the wait. Thank you so much, Anna. That was lovely.
Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody.
I'm glad it finally worked out.
I'm happy too.
Technology cannot be against us forever, right?
So. Yes. Well, I picked the phone, so this mobile is better now.
Ah. Well, I'm glad that it worked. Thank you again.
Thank you. Bye, then.
I am going to sign off with you now because I have 45 seconds left here. So we will say goodbye for now and we'll try to catch up with you. Oh, she's gone. So I've only got like 30 seconds left. I'll just say so long to everybody. Thank you so much for joining us again this week. Please send me feedback. Let me know what you would like to see or do or talk about. I'm always anxious to, try something different, try something new. And we will meet again next Wednesday, or maybe we'll change it up and change it to a different day or something. Just let me know what you would like. And okay, goodbye, everybody. Bye. Stay safe, stay inside, stay healthy.